Now that we have the columns and the beams, we're going to set up the joists. So we can start by going to L2, and it's actually under the structure tab, beam system. Beam system, we can actually draw the boundary lines or select them. I want to pick up the two beams on the two corners, and then I want to select the two lines, make it a closed loop. Okay, and for the direction, beam direction, I just want to draw a direction to show the joists. Okay, if you take a look at the drawings, you see that these are the joists. They're 265 by 418, which we take care of soon. And the distance between each of them is 3048. So I'm going to here, I'm going to change this number to 3048, and I'm going to apply this. And finish this in here. Okay, if I select one of them, you see it's 175 by 646. So what I'm going to do is that I want to go to the beam, I want to edit type and duplicate one of the beams to make one beam, which is a 265 by 418. 265 418. So this is going to be 265 and 418 here. Okay, so I created the beam. I just want to hit escape now. I want to hit tab to be able to select the whole beam system. And if I scroll down, there is a beam type here. I can select the beam that I created from here, 265 by 480. Okay, and I can now go to the section to make sure it works correctly. This is the beam that we created, 265 by 418, okay. And it should be exactly on top of the beam in here, right? So I want to get this number. It's 89. So if I select the beam system that I created, actually I want to do it from a different view. I want to hit tab to be able to get the whole beam system, and I want to assign negative 89 in here. Okay, if I go back to the section, you see it's exactly on top of the beam. So this is the joist and that's the beam. I can now go to this level, this beam system. I can copy that and paste it to select the levels. I'm gonna go with L3 first. Okay, if I go to L3, and I need to make sure to change this to fine, also change the view range to change the bottom to L2 and the view depth to L2. Okay, and I can select this from here. This is also negative 89. We need to go back to the section to make sure that distance is correct here as well. Okay, I want to go back to L3, hit tab, that's 89, and I should go with 89 plus 38, 127. I want to change this number to negative 127. If I go here, you see that it's exactly aligned. Now, as you remember, we have a different plan for the roof, which is this one. And I want to check the joists in here to see if the dimensions are different. Actually, it is. So you see the purlins here or the joists, they are 215 by 380. So what I can do is that I go to L3, select the system, copy and paste it to the roof. Okay, now I want to go to the roof. I only need to change the type. As you see, the beam type is 265 by 418. I want to go to the structure tab to beam, edit type, duplicate and create a new one, which is 215 by 380. 215 by 380. 215 by 380, okay, so this should be 380, that should be 215, okay. Make sure to duplicate it, not rename it. 215 by 318, by 380, okay, my bad. That should be 380 in here. Okay, now I can hit tab to select the beam system and change the beam type from the properties. It should be 215 by 380. It's good now. Let's check it in the section. And it's exactly on top of the beam. So the beam system is all good. Next thing I need to do is to create the shear walls on this corner, as I showed you. So this is the shear wall. It says it's CLT 139V. 139V is a type, but it means the thickness of the wall is 139 millimeters and is CLT or cross-laminated timber. So you see we have shear walls here, here, and on the other side. Maybe I could go to level 1. I'm gonna go to structure, wall, edit type, duplicate. I want to name this as shear wall 139V. Edit, change the thickness to 139, and I want to change the material. Maybe I can create one new material. I want to rename it as CLT or cross laminated timber. I want to go to browser and type timber here. Now I want to select this. Okay, I can change the color in graphics. It makes it easier to follow up the material later. Okay, that's better. Okay, all good. Okay. Now I want to go like about 1 meter on this side, so 1,000. And maybe I can also go 1 meter on the other side, about 2 meters of shear wall in here. And I want it to go from level 1 to the roof. I want to assign zeros to the offsets for now. Hit apply. If I go to the 3D view, that's the one, okay. Later I need to copy it here and on the other side. So let's do it now. I want to copy. Actually, how about I use this item for the copy, go to here. And I want to select these two. They go from level 1 to level roof. Copy them on the other side. Okay, let me show you how it looks like here. As you see, the beams are actually cut where we have the shear wall. I'm gonna do the same here. How about I go to L2? I'm gonna go here, select this beam. I wanna use split element. I wanna delete this part and use align or AL to match this in here. Also for the other side, I want to split here and here, delete this element, and use a line to match the beam with the shear wall. If I go to the 3D view, you see it's fixed in here. I need to do it for the upper floors. So as you see, the shear wall is continuous all the way to the roof on both sides. And the beams are cut where we have the shear wall.